Okay, so we will start with the addition of angular momenta, and we will discuss the Clebsch Gordan coefficients. And these come under the addition of angular momenta. So, first, let me make you understand the couplings. A coupling, it may be the orbital angular momenta coupling with the orbital angular momenta, or it may be the coupling of orbital with the spin angular momenta. So both are possible, and we know that if, for example, we are having one, let's say this is a classical angular momentum, and this body is rolling, and we are hearing this is L1, and then there is another body which is having the angular momentum is L2. Then we can add the two angular momenta, and I can, the head to tail rule, I can translate that angular momentum L2 here, and then I will have, this is the addition, which will be L, and this L is equal to L1 plus L2. This one is the addition of the two individual angular momenta. These are the orbital angular momentum. So the L, which is equal to L1 plus L2. Now this L can take any value, is a result of the addition of the two. We can have a situation that one is the orbital angular momentum and the other is the spin angular momentum. Or we can have the situation that both are spin angular momenta. Right? Both are spin angular momenta. So both the situations we can couple. The first we call, when the spin and the orbital are coupling, we call it spin orbit coupling. When two spin angular momenta are coupling, we will say this is the addition of the angular momenta. It is there, the spin coupling to the spin of a body or a particle. Now these, the Clebsch Gordan coefficients are the coefficients which we get as a result of the coupling of the two spins. We consider the hydrogen atom first, in which we consider the spin of electron and the spin of proton, means the electronic spin and the nuclear spin, and we are having the half-half spin combination. So this, we will derive such a table, and we will discuss other tables as well. This is the collection of the Clebsch Gordan coefficients, and we will come to know that how this table is derived. Okay, the very first thing, we will have to understand the Clebsch Gordan coefficients, and then we will derive them. So the first, now here, if we are having a quantum mechanical setup, so in a quantum mechanical, the values are quantized. When we consider the orbital angular momentum, it is having some quantized values. You remember that if I apply L square on a wave function, what I was getting? L and L plus 1 and h bar square psi. So L values were quantized, L0, 1, 2, 3, the orbital quantum number. These are quantized. Similarly, when I talk of the z component of it, then I also know that this one is quantized, ML. And h bar and psi. So the mns are quantized. It is running from minus n to plus n including zero. These are quantized. When I come to the spin, then I know that the spin is also quantized following such relations like s square on sin will be s into s plus 1 h bar square sin. Sz on this will give you ms in h bar. So the same terminologies are true for the spin angular momentum as well, as we were claiming the same for the orbital angular momentum. Now when we come to the couplings, so the total angular momentum J will be equal to L plus minus S, means the orbital angular momentum plus the spin angular momentum. If I take only the hydrogen atom and the electron is in the S orbit, so the S orbit will give me L equal to 0, because the small L in the S orbit is 0, so we will have capital L equal to 0. There is no contribution to the total angular momentum from the orbital angular momentum. The total angular momentum is the spin angular momentum. So I can say for the S orbit, this J and S are actually the same thing for the S orbit, L equal to 0. And I will start now from here, that the representation that I was doing is S and M. This representation I was doing, now I can do that with J M. Because J, this is small s, this is small j. When this will be capital S, this will be capital J. When this will be, this is small m, when this will be capital M, here I will write capital M. So the S and J are now the same thing, because no contribution from the orbital angular momentum. So you keep this thing in mind. And we will consider that example. So the very first, let me write the definition of what are the Clebsch Gordan coefficients. So I, in short, I call them CG coefficients. Clebsch Gordan coefficients are the expansion coefficients, are the expansion coefficients are the expansion coefficients of total angular momentum. The total angular momentum eigen states, eigenstates in uncoupled, in uncoupled product basis. So we will discuss that what are the coupled and uncoupled states. Let me consider an example, and that example is of, let me consider an example, and that example I will consider the two spin half particles. So J1 is half and J2 is half. So two spin half particles. And now, how these two angular momenta are coupled with each other, let me write them. So J1, M1, okay, even not to write comma between them, it is understood. And this one will be coupling. So this is the coupling symbol that I am writing with J2. And 2. So this is equal to, now write them. We have already discussed them, that what are these two things. You know, when the two spin half particles were coupling, we were getting two states. One was the singlet state, in which one configuration was there. Another was the triplet state, in which three states were there. So I can write J1, and it will be J1 will be half. So what will be M1? M1 will be half. And it will couple with half, means J2 half, and the possibility for the M2 is half. This was one configuration. Similarly, I can have one half, and then it's coupling with one half and minus one half, mean one will spin down. This is the M, this is G. And here I can have one half minus one half, and it will couple with half half. Similarly, I can have one half minus one half, and it's coupling with one half minus one half. Now this combination is that we are giving the spin, this is half. Forget about the first one, this will remain half in all, because J is half. These are the M's. So this spin is up, this spin is up. Spin up, spin down. Spin down, spin up. Spin down, spin down. These were the four configurations that we were having. And now, these are, you know, the values. We were writing them in this form as well, that this one, if I want to write them in the form of M1 and M2, then how we were writing them? This one is spin up, spin up. This one is spin up, while this one is spin down minus half. This one is spin down, spin up, and this one spin down here and spin down. So I only write the values of M1 and M2. Now you remember that this was the, these I call is the product basis. These are the product form. This is also a product form, is in the form of M1A, M2. And they will couple, and we will get something that these will go, these states. Okay, better I should have written here in order to understand this thing more. So let me write them here, that when these will go, okay, let me write this a bit close here. So I can write them in the form of M1 and M2, like this. So what it will be? The first stage, both the spins are while in the second stage, one spin is up, the other is down. In this one, one spin is down, this spin is up. And here, this spin is down, and the other spin is down as well. And now I see that these states go to coupled state. And for the coupled state, I will write J, capital J, capital M. Now, you know that capital J values and the capital M values. What was the possibility? The possibility was that the capital J value will be less than or equal to J1 plus J2. The two will add up, and this will be greater or equal to J1 minus J2, but this will be absolute because the J value will be positive. Now when half minus half, it is zero. So the minimum value of J is zero, equal or greater, and the maximum value half plus half, one. So we were hearing the J values is zero and one. While M values are always equal to M1 plus M2. So how many possible values we will have? Half plus half, one. Then zero. Then another configuration, zero. And then minus one. So these are the possible values of M. So I can write that these coupled states will be, what will be this state? J will be equal to 1 here because half plus half, J is 1. And M is 1 as well, half plus half. So I can write that this state will be 1.